Hello, my name is Iheoma Umez-Eronini. I am the Director of Compassion and Justice Ministries here at the River, and I'm excited this morning to celebrate the completion of renovation at four of the apartments, part of the River's Grace Village Ministry. So over 19 months ago, the River was invited to partner with City Team Ministries in providing shelter for women and children in need. It was an ambitious project. City Team was seeking to raise millions of dollars to purchase an old 50-unit apartment building and inviting churches to partner by renovating these units. It was at that time that we entered what I would describe as a feeding of the 5,000 type story. In John 6, you hear the text of it. The feeding of the 5,000 occurs when the crowd gathers to hear words of life and hope from Jesus. After a long day, the disciples urge Jesus to turn them away so that they can find food to eat, but Jesus charges them to meet their needs. Incredulous and doubtful, nonetheless, Andrew, one of the disciples, finds a child with two fish and five loaves of bread, and it is offered, wondering, how far will it go among so many needs? We know how the story ends. Jesus takes that little, blesses it, multiplies it, and it ends up being more than sufficient for the needs of everyone. They even gathered 12 basketfuls at the end. We have entered a feeding of the 5,000 type story because similarly, the need for shelter in San Jose is overwhelming. When invited to partner with City Team, we bought the need before our congregation as part of our Advent giving, and our church's generosity was astounding. We raised enough money, not just for one unit, my small size faith, but for four units. And after 19 months of faithful labor and stewardship, I'm here to share how God has blessed our offering of fish and loaves and how it has met the needs of so many. So please enjoy this video of celebration.
Have it be a nice place for people to live and not just kind of the bare minimum. But I also think it will help to revitalize this neighborhood of downtown San Jose, which needs some hope and needs some good things happening in it. So we're excited for it, and I'm excited to think of all of the families that will live here.
Brad at one point talked about how it was important for Christian groups not to just be insular, but to be looking out at how they could pursue the good of their city. And to me, this is the perfect example of a way to do that, of to go out. It's a little bit of cross-cultural stuff, but it's also just in our area and in our city and with our spare time, is figure out how we can do something that pursues the good of the city. This is great. City Team is one of those groups that I've admired for a long time, and I'm really happy to help and support them. Thank you.
Good morning, River Church. I've been asked to share my thoughts on our recently completed project over at Grace Village. So I come away from that project just feeling a deep sense of gratitude, and for so many reasons. First off, for just initially Iheoma asking if I would volunteer to lead construction. Of course I said yes, because it is such an awesome, worthwhile project, and it ties in with the skills that I have. So it was never a question whether I would say yes or not. I do remember though thinking, oh, I guess I'll have to give up my Saturday morning pickleball for a few weeks, or possibly, you know, a couple of months. Little did I know that this project would actually span 19 months. I don't think Iheoma had any idea. I don't think anybody at the River, I don't think anybody at City Team expected this project to actually take that long. So it's just incredible thinking back on, you know, the duration of that project. But that ties into another thing that I'm very grateful for, is the fact that God did stretch this project out to last that long, because I think in doing that, he was able to do a work in me that probably wouldn't be as impactful if the project had only lasted a few weeks or, you know, a couple of months. The fact that it lasted 19 months allowed him to really penetrate deep into my heart and my soul in a really good way. So thankful to God. I'm also thankful to all the volunteer leaders that stepped up over the weeks to bridge the gap, the times that I couldn't be there. They really helped keep the project moving along so that it wouldn't stagnate and keep the momentum going. So many reasons to be grateful for this project. And I think it'll go down as a core memory for me that will last the rest of my life.